கருணாகர சூரீந்திர குருவர்ய பதாம்புஜாம் நவநீத நடோத்தம் சாம் குருபங்க்தி ஸ்ரீயன்னுமஹா. த ஸ்டோரி ஆஃப் தொண்டரடிப்பொடி ஆழ்வார். வி ஹவ் பீன் லிஸ்னிங் டு த ஸ்டோரிஸ் ஆஃப் ஆழ்வார்ஸ் சின்ஸ் சம் டைம் நவ். ஆழ்வார்ஸ் ஆர் டீப்லி டிவோட்டட் சேண்ட்ஸ் ஹூ ஆர் டெடிக்கேட்டட் டு தி சர்வீஸ் ஆஃப் லார்ட் ஸ்ரீமன் நாராயணா. Some of the Alvars are known to be the incarnations of the divine weapons or the divine ornaments of Lord Sriman Narayana or the celestials present in Sri Vaikuntha, also known as the Nitya Suris. Today, we shall be listening to the story of Thondaradippodi Alvar. Thondaradippodi Alvar took his incarnation in a Brahmin family who resided at Thirumandangudi, which is a small village on the banks of the river Kaveri. Thondaradippodi Alvar incarnated in a Prabhava year in the month of Margali when it was a Krishna Paksha Chaturdashi according to the lunar calendar. The day was a Tuesday and the prevailing star was Ketai. Thondaradippodi Alvar is known to be the incarnation of the Vaijayanti Mala, the colorful garland that adorns the chest of Lord Sriman Narayana. When he incarnated, his parents named this divine child as Vipra Narayana. Vipra Narayana learnt all the scriptures from his father and later on moved to Srirangam. There, he created a lovely garden and plucked flowers from that garden to make beautiful garlands for Lord Ranganatha every day. One day, it so happened that a dancer in the court of the Chola king was passing by the garden. She was attracted to the beauty of the garden and tried to look into it more closely. The name of this dancer was Devadevi. She had come here along with her sister. Devadevi's sister informed her that this garden belonged to Vipra Narayana, who was a great Vishnu Bhakta. Just as she said this, Vipra Narayana entered the garden from his hut and started collecting flowers. He did not even notice these two maidens standing there. Such was his devoted concentration to plucking flowers and making garlands for the Lord. That was the sole purpose of his life, he thought. Seeing that he hadn't noticed them, Devadevi's sister challenged her that nobody could attract Vipra Narayana, who was nothing less than an ascetic. Even the very beautiful Devadevi, who could capture the attention of one and all, could not succeed in diverting the attention of Vipra Narayana, said her sister. She threw this as a challenge and Devadevi accepted the challenge and said that she would somehow make Vipra Narayana turn towards her and be by her side. To put her words into action, Devadevi disguised as a female saint and offered her services to Vipra Narayana. Vipra Narayana initially did not agree to taking services from Devadevi, but she insisted that she wanted to be a part of the divine service that he was doing to the Lord. So finally, Vipra Narayana agreed on the condition that she would stay outside the hermitage. He continued doing his Pushpa Kaikaryam towards Lord Ranganatha, and Devadevi would assist him in plucking flowers and cleaning the garden and doing mundane chores around his hut. On one rainy day, Devadevi got drenched outside the hut of Vipra Narayana. Looking at her plight, Vipra Narayana thought she needed shelter and let her inside his hermitage. Slowly, Devadevi trapped Vipranarayana with her charm. And since then, Vipranarayana forgot his duties towards the Lord and spent all his time with the dancer. The dancer Devadevi started exploiting him by taking away all the wealth that he had. He did not have much, but whatever little resources he had were all taken away by her. And finally, when she realized that he had no more money left, she also left him. Unable to forget her, Vipranarayana went behind her to her house, but she refused to see him unless he had something to give to her. Lord Ranganatha was seeing all these happenings. He was watching how his once upon a time devoted Bhakta got diverted by worldly attraction. The Lord now decided that it was time to make his devotee realize his mistake. So he played a beautiful drama where the Lord himself went to Devadevi's house in the disguise of Vipranarayana's servant and offered her a golden cup from the temple, a golden vattil. He said that he had been sent by Vipranarayana with this gift to appease her. Devadevi was very happy to receive this expensive gift and immediately sent a message with the boy saying that she wanted to see Vipranarayana. This message was conveyed to Vipranarayana in a dream, and the Lord went back to the temple. Vipranarayana was overjoyed that Devadevi had called him, and he went rushing to her house. Meanwhile, the golden cup at the temple was missing, and everybody started searching for it. The whole city of Srirangam was searched for, and finally, the cup was found at Devadevi's house. She was considered being culprit here. But Devadevi defended herself, saying that this golden vattil was gifted to her by Vipranarayana and it actually came to her through his servant. Vipranarayana was completely clueless about the entire information. He in fact did not even know that Devadevi had called him because she received this golden cup. So he pleaded innocence and said that he had never heard of or even seen such a golden vessel and he did not have any servant to send to Devadevi. But nobody was ready to listen to Vipranarayana's explanations. So the king's men caught him and threw him in the prison. While he was at the prison, Vipranarayana wondered who had gone as his servant to Devadevi's house. And on thinking hard, he realized that it must indeed have been the Lord who did this to make me understand how wrong it was to forget about his kaikaryam. Vipranarayana had complete realization that day and repentance washed his soul clean. Similarly, even Devadevi realized her mistake at the time. She thought, had she not accepted her sister's challenge to attract Vipranarayana, all these things would have never happened. She had made a saint lose his path of virtue. She had been the reason for him committing such a huge sin. And so, hers was a greater sin than his. She too realized her mistake and wept inconsolable tears of repentance. That very night, the Lord also appeared in the king's dream and narrated all the events connected around the missing golden vattil. He explained how it was he who had gone as a servant to deliver the gift to Devadevi. He ordered the king to release his innocent Bhakta Vipranarayana.
The king too realized that he too had committed a mistake. He immediately released Vipranarayana and sought his pardon. Vipranarayana consoled the king, saying that it was Lord Ranganatha's way of correcting everybody's mistakes and proving that he would never let go of a devotee. If a devotee was pursuing a wrong path for some reason, the Lord would ensure that he corrects the devotee and gets him back to the righteous path. After these events, Vipranarayana became more devoted to the Lord, and he surrendered himself to Lord Ranganatha and his divine service. He called himself as Thondar Adipodi Alvar. Thondar Adipodi refers to the dust in the feet of the Lord's devotees. He said he was like mere dust at the feet of the great devotees of the Lord. He said sanctity was accepting the sesha, or the remains of what a Lord's devotee would give him as food. Ponagam seida sedam taruvarel punidamandre, he says. He realized his characteristic or swarupam very well. The true characteristic of a devotee is to respect other devotees and to feel that he is a servant of a true devotee of the Lord. And this realization came to Thondar Adipodi Alvar, making him perfectly suitable for the name that he had taken up. Thondar Adipodi Alvar composed two works, namely the Tiruppalli Ezhuchi, which comprises of 10 verses, and the Tirumalai, which comprises of 45 verses. Tiruppalli Ezhuchi refers to the verses which awaken the Lord in the mornings. It is like the Suprabhatam, which is sung for the Lord of Tirumala. Tiruppalli Ezhuchi is sung across all Vishnu temples in the world to wake up the Lord every morning. So, Thondar Adipodi Alvar's verses seem to be very close to the heart of the Lord, because he wishes to open himself out to devotees after listening to these divine verses every morning. In the Tirumalai, Thondar Adipodi Alvar quotes many beautiful aspects which speak about how humble we must be when we serve the Lord. This Alvar was extremely attached to Lord Ranganatha of Srirangam and said that he would want to always enjoy and be of service to this Lord at Srirangam, and probably not even wish to attain the eternal abode if he were given a choice to be able to serve the Lord at Srirangam. Pachai Mamalai Pol Meni Pavalavai Kamalachengan Achyuta Amarere Ayartham Kolunde Ennum Ichuvai Thavirayan Poi Indiralokam Aalum Achyuvai Perinum Vendeen Arangaman Agarulani. Alvar says, when I can see this beautiful blue-green hued mountain-like structure in front of my eyes, the most beautiful Lord having coral-like lips and lotus-like eyes, if I can behold him always and serve him, I would not even want the kingship of Sri Vaikuntha. Even if the Lord were to make me the royal heir of Sri Vaikuntha, I would still not prefer that over looking at the Lord at Srirangam like this. Such was the devotion of Thondar Adipodi Alvar to the Lord of Srirangam. So, let us all sing the praise of Thondar Adipodi Alvar as told by Swami Deshikan in his Prabandha Saram. மன்னுமதில் திருமண்டங்குடிதான் வாழ மார்கழி மாத கேட்டை நாளில் வந்து துன்னு புகழ் தொண்டரடி பொடியே நீ முன் துழாய் மாலை பணியடிமை செய்து நாளும் தென்னரங்க மணவாளர்க்கு அன்பு மிக்க செப்பிய நற்திருமாலை 45 பண்ணிய நற்திருப்பள்ளி 710 பழவடியேனுக்கருள் செய் பரிந்து நீயே தொண்டரடிப்பொடியாழ்வார் திருவடிகளே சரணம்.